You want to launch a successful crowdfunding campaign. You're going to launch your product, your service, your business. You're going to use this money, this revenue, this exposure to take you to the next level. There are three foundational keys you need for a successful campaign. And if you do not do all three things really, really well, your campaign will fail. What I love about working with people in your situation, people who want to be able to go to market, build a community of people to support them, and then actually make this happen, is that it takes a lot of courage. And I think that's admirable. But where people run into trouble is they don't realize that you don't need just a video. You don't need just the right copy on the page. So people reach out to me all the time. And when they do, they say, I need a really great video, or I need some help setting up this campaign. And so we start to ask some really easy and obvious questions. Where are you in the business? Are you an established running business and you happen to be launching a new product? Are you launching an add-on to an existing product? Or are you pre-revenue? Are you pre-startup even? Do you even have prototypes developed, or is this really conceptual? What type of platform do you want to go on? Kickstarter, Indiegogo, something else? These types of questions are really important because depending on where you are in your business life cycle, it will impact how you're perceived, because the credibility that you bring in to making this thing happen is a huge challenge for people. Let me take a step back and explain. So you want to launch this campaign, and no matter where you are in it, you need the revenue, you need the money for a certain reason. What a lot of people don't realize is a really successful Kickstarter or Indiegogo campaign is as much work or more work than actually launching your business. Running a successful campaign requires you to understand what is the product and who am I speaking to, and what does this look like and what does this feel like, and I need video assets and photography assets, and I need a landing page, and I need a message, and I need a sales message, and I need my perks, and I need everything figured out. All of that stuff that you need to figure out is the first foundational element. I call that the story. We need your product or your service or your brand to have a really great story. Why do you exist? Why was it created? Who is it for? How will it help them? Can it stand up to scrutiny? Can it actually be done? How much are you asking for? How will you use those dollars? Can you be trusted? Who else is doing this? That's just a handful of questions. There are like literally 100 more questions you need to be able to answer. But you need this story. You need a story for your brand, for your product. We call this brand strategy. But you know what? When Apple launches a new phone, you better believe that there's a story behind it. Why did they go from the 8 to the 10? Why did they launch, you know, the Apple iPhone X? Why did they release them at the same time? There's a story, there's a rationale, there's an explanation for why they're doing this. Why are you doing this? And in this first foundational element of story, this does start to impact not only your brand strategy, not only what you look like, sound like, or feel like. Yes, video plays into this. How does a video contribute to the success of your campaign? Your landing page. What are you saying on the page, and what order are you saying it? Do you have the credibility you need? There's no way around it. Every successful campaign has a really great justification and reason they exist. They have a why. They have a purpose. The stuff makes sense. They're being clear. They're being transparent. All of that stuff has to happen. And so again, yes, you need a video, you need photography, you need a landing page, you need all of those things, you need your perks sorted out, but that's the first bucket. What is the story? And then that takes us to the second key pillar, and that's PR. The more niche your campaign is, the more niche your product is, the more successful you can be. If you're starting out your business pre-revenue and you don't have an email marketing list, you don't have a lot of connections, you don't have everyone you need or haven't broken into that industry, you don't have the persona, you need really active and really strong PR. Every successful campaign has an investment in PR. You're hiring a PR company, you're figuring out the top 50 bloggers who are within your niche industry. You're figuring out what journalists at what online publications have written about this in the past. You're looking at where your competitors are advertising from a PR point of view. And you are looking to make sure that you don't have a Me Too story. Remember that story thing? For PR, you need a really great story. You need a reason that people will look at you and think about you and consider you. You need some curiosity. You need some interest. Your product for the marketplace has to have a unique story. And then if you're successful, if you get funded within the first 24 hours, if you start to do certain perks, when your PR starts to pick up, the campaign itself becomes a story, right? The story is the launch. Then the story becomes, look at how successful our campaign is. And then the story becomes, hey, look at our close of our campaign and look at what we're doing now with the money. And there's story after story after story. But you have to invest money. You have to invest time in PR. Posting your project up on one of these platforms will not do anything. You will not get funded. You will not get seen. So the most successful campaigns not only have all of this story figured out, they have a really strong investment in PR. And then the last thing you need is community management. A lot of clients we work with underestimate how much work community management is. And that's an extension of story and PR, but you can call it customer service, you can call it answering questions, whatever it is. Let's say that your campaign is starting to take off. I've seen campaigns where people hate the idea, hate the people, hate the concept so much, they will fund the campaign so that way they have an opportunity to go into your community and leave comments. And then they will roast you, they will flame you, they will destroy you. They will point out every single element of your story that is inauthentic or doesn't make sense or where they think you're trying to lie to them or scam them. So community management is so important because you may start to get people funding you, but are they going to back out? What if you're delayed? What if you're late? What if you're not answering questions? What if they have questions about shipping or about other things? Every single thing within this is this house of cards where the littlest hint, the littlest belief that you are trying to scam them will lead to a wildfire of people who think you're trying to scam them. You need a really great story. You need really strong PR. You have to have community management. This is like a full-time person's job for 30, 45, 60 days. They're answering inbound questions. They're sending out emails. You're doing stretch goals. They're maybe dealing with press questions that come in. You have to stay on top of the community management. And so when people come to me and they say, hey, I need a video or I need some help with these things, they're only thinking of one portion of the first part. And when I start to ask about what are we doing for story, if you're a company that's pre-revenue, if you haven't gone through a comp analysis for your competitors or brand strategy, you may have a logo, but that's not enough. Who are you as a company? What are you trying to do? That has to be established. What is the rationale behind the perks? These projects, these campaigns are not pre-sales. No one is gonna come and say, oh, good news, I get a 20% discount. No one gives a shit about a 20% discount. What reason do I have to support you to risk my money to buy something potentially early that may not happen for 20% discount when I can just wait? Right? I'll just wait 6 months and I'll get it. I'll pay 20% more, but at least I know it's happening. At least I know it's real. At least I can see consumer reviews and feedback. Now, here's the thing. I'm assuming that you need a fairly large amount of money. If you need $4,000, $5,000, $10,000, you're not gonna pay someone like us. You're not gonna do PR. You're not gonna do these things. You don't need to focus on it that hard. It's still a lot of work. Still as much work as launching your own business, but you don't have to focus on it that much. If you're looking for 75, 100, 200, half a million, $2 million, you better believe that people are investing a lot of money upfront into these things. And so now you might say, well, why would I invest all of this money into something if there's no guarantee it will work? That's the question. If it's as much work and it's as much money invested in launching this campaign and risk failing in front of everyone as it is launching your business, why wouldn't you just launch your business to begin with? That's the question. And so if you have access to capital and you can just launch your business, you can take all of those budgets and all of those dollars that you're going to invest here and simply launch your business. Half of the clients we work with who come to us for these conversations end up just launching their business anyway. But if you need the investment, if you need the capital, if you need access to that money, or if you need to prove in market that there's interest in it for something much bigger, then you have to go this route. But you have to realize it's as much work and as much money and as much investment as just launching the dang company. There's no way around this. This is not the easy, fast solution. It's a lot of work. So then the last thing you might be saying is, why would anyone invest all of those dollars and all those times in something that may not work? So here's the question I want you to ask yourself. Whether your campaign is successful or not, will you launch your product anyway? Come hell or high water, you will launch your company and launch your product. If you will launch your product no matter what, you will launch your service or company no matter what, then you may want to consider investing in all of those assets anyway. Because here's what's happened in real world situations. We had a client who came and worked with us. We produced all of these great assets. We produced the story for them, the rationale for them. We helped them produce the perks and all of those things. And we really helped them shape everything that it was about their company. Their goals were super, super lofty. Over $900,000 in funding they wanted. They got to $450,000. So they were not funded. They failed. They failed with $450,000. That's pretty amazing. So they failed, but they had our assets. They had our video. They had our photography. They had our story. They were going to launch the company whether they were successful or not. And then they went out and they actually sold their technology for a military government grant because they figured out that there was a connection between what they were doing and R&D. Now, they used our assets to do so. It's a pretty cool story. We had another client who was successful, who we shot all the video, we did all the stories, we did everything else for them. They were looking for, $50,000, $60,000. I think they ended at $450,000. But for an entire year after the success and after the launch, they not only used our assets in the campaign, they not only used our assets in press, but then for every single trade show, every single pitch, every single meeting going forward, they used our assets to do that for a year. Then when they launched their product, because they were so successful, we had to reshoot all those assets because the product slightly changed. So they paid us to reshoot everything, redo everything with the new product. And then they used that for an entire year and got licensed by this huge North American company. They used our assets in Target end caps. They used it for retail distribution. These little things that we shot for them. Then the third year comes around and they're now ready for a commercial campaign. We developed something completely new for them. It was a pretty cool project. But they were going to launch their product whether they were successful or not. They were investing in assets that were foundational for their business. And then they used them for every sales pitch, every single meeting, every single finance person, getting the factories in China on board. They used it for everything to prove that they are a real company, a legit company, and should be taken seriously. Now, as you're launching your business, you have to ask yourself if that's important. If it is, you may want to consider scrounging up the cash or doing whatever it is you have to do in order to pay for these assets right now because they will be so foundationally important for the 6 months, the 9 months, the 1 year ahead. If you're not going to launch your business no matter what, this is all a bit of a test. If the idea of investing a lot of dollars, and by a lot of dollars, I mean like 15, 35, 50, 80, 100 grand. If the idea of investing anywhere from 15 to 100 grand in a project where you're only trying to get 50 or 100 grand out of it, if that seems ludicrous to you, then you will want to try and do this as low budget as possible. You'll want to try and answer those questions I talked about, build your own story. You will want to try and do as much PR as you can, finding the top 50 bloggers, finding the article people, reaching out to them, maybe mailing them versions of your package or whatever it is. And then you will want to do the community management yourself. Those are the foundational elements for a successful crowdfunding campaign. I'm not here to convince you. I'm not here to pitch you. I'm not here to tell you what to do. I want you to be aware of it because you have to have the formula right. And you cannot think that it's the easy thing to do. It's a fuckload of work. It really is. But it is totally awesome. It's totally worth it. And it's a great path for some people. Let me know if you think there are additional tips, tricks, or other things that I left out, skimmed over, or glossed over. And like always, I want you to think big. I want you to be bold. And I want you to say yes. If growing and scaling your business by being better at sales and better at marketing, better at customer experience is important to you, be sure to check out this video right over here. And like always, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon, and get each video every day when it drops.